What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? This is your brother, your friend, Apostle Makhario, coming to you all again. This is part three of our topic of the Trinity. We're getting into it. As I told you in part one, the day before part one, the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me and told me to teach on the Trinity as I was doing my daily studies. Now, we all should study the Bible daily more than once, okay? For me, my schedule normally is first thing when I wake up, last thing before I go to sleep. And sometimes even in between, but in between the day, normally we're going about our day, so I just meditate on the word. Whatever I studied, I do my best to meditate on that scripture or those scriptures throughout the day, and God will constantly just tie it in, and next thing you know, you got a message. But we're talking about the true Trinity, which is God the Father, Jesus Christ the Son, and the Holy Spirit, okay? I know that there are some people that don't like the word Trinity. Does not mean that it does not exist. Trinity in God is God the Father, Jesus Christ the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So I'm going to take you to the scripture and the verse that God told me when he spoke to me to teach on the Trinity. Okay, so that is Luke chapter 12, starting at verse 6. And it says, "Are not five sparrows sold for 2 farthings, and not one of them is forgotten before God?" So something else I taught you in parts 1 and 2 is that they will always be distinct when they're referenced. Very few times that the Bible says us or we, and they're talking about God the Father, Jesus Christ the Son, and the Holy Spirit. As I told you, when you go back in Genesis, when God said, "Let us make man in our image and in our likeness," okay, that was all three. But it says in verse 7, "But even the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear not, therefore," this is Jesus speaking, remember that, "ye are of more value than many sparrows. Also I say unto you, whosoever shall confess me before men, him shall the Son of Man also confess before the angels of God. But he that denieth me before men shall be denied before the angels of God. And whosoever shall speak a word against the Son of Man," that's Jesus speaking of himself, "it shall be forgiven him. But unto him that blasphemeth against the Holy Ghost, it shall not be forgiven him," or shall not be forgiven. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, it's distinctly mentioned God, Jesus Christ, or the Son of Man, and then the Holy Ghost, or the Holy Spirit. So that shows you once again in the New Testament that there is a Trinity, okay? And we're going to go to verse 12, actually. "And when they bring you unto the synagogue and unto the magistrates and powers, take no thought how or what ye shall answer or what ye shall say." This was Jesus telling you, don't take thought. Verse 12, "For the Holy Ghost shall teach you in the same hour what ye ought to say." So once again, ladies and gentlemen, as I said before, distinctly mention God, the Son of Man, or Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Going to John, we're going to do John chapter 14, verse 12 first. This was Jesus speaking again, and Jesus saying that if you believe on him, in him, the Comforter, okay? It's a lot of things, but John 14, 12, this is going to be about God and Jesus. Jesus is speaking, but he mentions the Father distinctly, separately. So John 14, 12, it says, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do shall he do also, and greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father." So once again, God the Father, Jesus Christ the Son, and of course the Holy Spirit is the one that has you operate in that power. Then we're going to go to John 14, same book, same chapter, but verse 26. Jesus distinctly, now this is Jesus speaking again, but distinctly mentioning the Holy Ghost and God the Father. It says, "But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost." Now remember that, the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, because the Holy Ghost is also known as a Comforter. "Whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance whatsoever I have said unto you." So once again, all three operate in one. They all agree. They are never in disagreement. So if somebody says, God said this, Jesus said that, the Holy Spirit said that, and they all contradict each other, that's a lie. They never disagree, and I'm going to show you that in Scripture. But Jesus said here, the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, okay, Whom the Father will send in my name, he shall in my name. So that's all three in the same sentence. He shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance whatsoever I've said unto you. So ladies and gentlemen, there is a Trinity. That Trinity is God the Father, Jesus Christ the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And I told you there is a hierarchy. God is first. Jesus Christ is second. The Holy Spirit comes third. Yet they all agree in one. Okay? So there's different levels of power. I should put it that way. God gives all the orders. Jesus Christ is the one that helps you find out how to obey them. And the Holy Spirit leads you into obeying them. Comforts you in knowing that in your obedience, God is still going to answer and fulfill and bless you. Then we're going to go to John chapter 16. We're going to start at verse 7. Jesus speaking again about how he has to leave. It's expedient for him to leave, okay? John chapter 16, verse 7. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you. And when he is come, he will reprove the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment. So Jesus said, I have to depart because then the Comforter will come, which is the Holy Spirit or the Holy Ghost. And he said, then the Holy Ghost will reprove or rebuke or correct the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment. Okay, it says in verse 9, of sin because they believe not on me. Saying the world doesn't believe on Jesus. And I talked to you about that in part 2. Of righteousness, because I go to my Father and ye see me no more. So notice again, distinctly, they're all being mentioned. He said the Comforter, the Holy Ghost. He said, they believe not on me, Jesus Christ. And then he said, because I go unto my Father, you'll know righteousness. Of judgment, because the prince of this world is judged. The prince of this world being Satan, Lucifer, the enemy. Okay? Now, as I said, there are three parts operating in one. Okay, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. And I told you they never disagree. Shall never disagree. Always be in agreement. If you go to 1 John, toward the end of the Bible, okay, 1 John chapter 5. And this is what I mean when I say they always agree, they never disagree. The Holy Spirit, Jesus Christ, and God the Father will never contradict each other. Never, ever. Okay, I don't care what man tells you. I don't care what other people teach you. They shall never contradict one another. It says here in 1 John chapter 5, we're going to start at verse 3. For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous. For whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. So you're saying if you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and you're born of God, which means you become the actual child of God. The world says we're all children of God. That's not true. The Bible says in Galatians 3:26, for ye are the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus. We're all God's creation. We're not all his children. That's a whole nother revelation. I believe I taught on it many years ago, so if you go back in the videos, you'll start to see that. But 1 John chapter 5, verse 5, who is he that overcometh the world but he that believeth that Jesus Christ is what? The Son of God. Okay? Verse 6, this is he that came by water and blood, even Jesus Christ, not by water only, but by water and blood, and it is the Spirit that beareth witness, because the Spirit is truth. So it talks about God, it talks about Jesus, and it talks about the Spirit of God, which is the Holy Spirit. Verse 7. Remember, I told you they always agree. Never disagree. Always in agreement. All three operate in one. You're going to see that. For there are three that bear record in heaven. Okay? The Father, God, the Word, Jesus, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one. I don't care what other religion tells you that there is not a Trinity. I don't care how close they seem to be to God. If they're telling you that there is not God the Father, Jesus Christ the Son, and the Holy Spirit, They're contradicting the word of God, and they're not teaching you the truth. Verse 8, let's continue, because it says these three bear witness in heaven in verse 7, for there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one. Okay, verse 8, and there are three that bear record in earth, the Spirit, the water, and the blood, and these three agree in one. It says in verse 9, if we receive the witness of men, the witness of God is greater, for this is the witness of God, which he hath testified of his Son. Once again, distinctly mentioned. Verse 7, three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one. Verse 8, and there are three that bear witness in earth, the Spirit, the water, and the blood, and these three agree in one. So, ladies and gentlemen, there is a Trinity. Let no man deceive you. God the Father, Jesus Christ the Son of God, and the Holy Spirit or the Holy Ghost or the Comforter. All three agree in one, never in disagreement, always bear record together, always together. Okay? So I love you all. I will see you all again soon. I pray that this blesses your spirit. I'm sure that it will, because once again, it's overflowing. And remember that the Comforter, the Holy Ghost, comes with his own language as well, which is speaking in tongues. It is real. You don't have to wait till the Holy Ghost hits you. You can speak in it at all times. Prime example. Okay, so it's not when you can't catch the spirit. Okay, that's like saying you catch it like it's the flu. No, the Spirit of God dwells within you. And remember, that's used to help you build yourself up in your most holy faith. When people pray in tongues or in the Holy Ghost or in the Spirit of God, they're building themselves up. It's a language that Satan or man cannot understand unless God gives them the interpretation, which also comes from the Holy Ghost. If you go and study Corinthians, 1 Corinthians, and it gives you that level of power. It helps your prophetic be more accurate. Demons can get cast out through speaking in tongues. Okay, they feel the fire of God through that. So, ladies and gentlemen, there are so many things, but remember, there is a Trinity. And that Trinity is God the Father, Jesus Christ the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Now, if you do not know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, I pray that you humble yourself today. And that you bow down and that you ask God to come into your heart. Ask God to forgive you of your sins. Ask Jesus Christ to come into your heart and ask the Holy Spirit to guide you into how to obey and walk and live the way that God the Father wants us to live. Because the Holy Ghost or the Comforter helps you discern. Actually, let me do this before I let you all go. We're going to touch a little bit on the Holy Spirit, okay? And 1 Corinthians... Man, it's so much. It's so much. There are gifts of the Spirit, okay? And that's... comes from being filled with the Holy Ghost, which is the third part of the Trinity. And 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 4. And I just want you all to know this because it's about teaching you all how to live for God. And to know that these things still happen today. Just as I spoke in tongues for you a moment ago. Healing, deliverance, casting out devils, miracles, signs, and wonders still happen today. And God is no respecter of persons. It's just about you living that lifestyle that God could be pleased with. And having integrity that God could pour out more anointing into your life. So 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Verse 4, now there are diversities of gifts, but the same Spirit. That's the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, the Comforter. And there are differences of administrations, but the same Lord. Okay? And there are diversities of operations, but it is the same God that worketh all in all. Verse 7, but the manifestations of the Spirit is given to every man to profit withal. Verse 8, for to one is given by the Spirit the word of wisdom. To another, the word of knowledge by the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, the gifts of healing by the same Spirit. to another, the working of miracles, to another, prophecy, to another, discerning of spirits, to another, diverse kinds of tongues, to another, interpretation of tongues. So that means it's 9 gifts of the Spirit, but they all come from the Holy Spirit. Okay? So ladies and gentlemen, I want you all to know this. When you receive the Holy Spirit and you begin to speak in tongues, these operations can begin to happen for you. Not that they won't begin to happen the moment that you receive Jesus. They all come together. But speaking in the Spirit is one thing. Speaking in tongues, as it says, diverse kinds of tongues, the interpretation of tongues. So speaking in tongues still happens today. And it's another level of power. If you continue to study, you'll see that. It's a language that Satan cannot understand and man cannot understand unless, as it says in 1 Corinthians 12, God gives them the interpretation of tongues. So ladies and gentlemen, I beseech you that if you don't speak in tongues, seek God for that. Study the Word of God, pray, and fast. And watch God do these things in your life. But you have to have integrity. What you do in darkness, you have to do in light. And what you do in light is the same thing you have to do in darkness. Remember, Jesus said, close yourself in your closet and pray before God. And what you do in secret, God will reward you openly. So when people see you operating in that power openly, they'll know that you must be doing something right in your private time with God. Because those that don't operate in that level of power or in those manifestations of the gifts of the Spirit don't do that. They don't pray before God. They're not seeking God privately. Many times you'll see them do it in church for a show to make people think they're living a certain way, but they're not actually living that way. They're not actually studying the Word of God. Okay? They're not actually fasting. They're not actually praying. But ladies and gentlemen, there is a Trinity, and I'm closing it out. It's hard when you're talking to a preacher, a teacher of the gospel, but there is a Trinity, and that is God the Father, Jesus Christ the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let no man deceive you. I've taken you through the scriptures, Old Testament and New, and shown you from Genesis, from the beginning of the Bible, the first 3 verses, it speaks of God, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Then I took you into Numbers, I took you into some other books of the Bible, and I took you into John, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, and then 1 John as well. And then I also took you into Corinthians, showing you that there is the Holy Spirit or the Comforter, and that it has diversities of gifts and operations. Now there are some of us that operate in all 9. You can do it. God will use it at different times for you to operate in all of them. Speaking in tongues never leaves. You can't catch the Holy Ghost and then the Holy Ghost is gone. I hear people say sometimes that I spoke in tongues once, but I haven't since then. That's only because you stopped trying to. It's only because you allowed your faith to waver. Because once you get filled with the Spirit of God, it doesn't leave. You can speak in tongues at will. You can pray in the Spirit, as the scripture says, at will. So I love you all. I will see you all again soon. May God bless. If you ever receive Jesus, I pray that you do. Even now, while you're watching this video, I pray that you receive Jesus. After this video, I pray that you humble yourself and receive Jesus. Because there is healing for you in receiving Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. In believing the Word of God, regardless of what society and man may say. Man looks at science as God. Science is not God. Man looks at money as God. If money was God, it would have saved a lot of people from dying, and it can't. Man looks at money and science together as being able to give them eternal life. That shall never happen. But ladies and gentlemen, when you have God the Father, Jesus Christ the Son, and the Holy Spirit, life eternal is yours. And you don't have to die of horrible diseases and sicknesses. I love you all. I will see you all again soon. May God bless. Study the Word of God. Pray and fast. And we are out.